great God of mercy, God of consolation, look on your people gathered here to praise you. Pity our weakness, come in power to aid us, source of all blessing. Jesus, Redeemer, God of all creation, come as our Savior, Jesus, friend of sinners, grant us forgiveness, lift our downcast spirit, heal us and save us.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, today's liturgy brings forth before us a very important theme for our relations, the theme of forgiveness. It challenges us today to do away with resentment, hostility, and the feeling of vengeance, and invite empathy, compassion, and affection towards others. Let us ask this grace in today's Eucharist for each one of us. But for the times when we have allowed this feeling of vengefulness, this feeling of resentment to boil within us, held grudges against others, and in the bargain sin against the Lord and our fellow brethren, let us ask the Lord for his forgiveness. With contrite heart, let us call to his mercy, and together we say,
I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May the Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us of all our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Kyrie eleison. Christ eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God Almighty Father, Jesus Christ, only begotten Son. Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. Look upon us, O God, Creator and ruler of all things, that we may feel the working of your mercy. Grant that we may serve you with all our heart, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Sirach. Anger and wrath, these all are abominations, and the sinful man will hold them fast. The one who seeks vengeance will be paid vengeance from the Lord, and he who keeps a record will have his own sins recorded. Forgive your neighbor the wrong he has done, and then your sins will be pardoned when you pray. Does one person harbor anger against another and yet seek for healing from the Lord? Does he have no mercy towards someone like himself and yet pray concerning his own sins? If he himself, being flesh, maintains wrath, who will make atonement for his sins? Remember the end of your life and cease from enmity. Remember destruction and death and be true to the commandments. Remember the commandments and do not be angry with your neighbor. Remember the covenant of the Most High and overlook error. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is compassionate and gracious, slow to anger and rich in mercy. The Lord is compassionate and gracious, slow to anger and rich in mercy.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all within me His holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and never forget all His benefits. The Lord is compassionate and gracious, slow to anger and rich in mercy. It is the Lord who forgives all your sins, who heals every one of your ills, who redeems your life from the grave, who crowns you with mercy and compassion. The Lord is compassionate and gracious, slow to anger and rich in mercy. He will not always find fault, nor persist in His anger forever. He does not treat us according to our sins, nor repay us according to our faults. The Lord is compassionate and gracious, slow to anger and rich in mercy. For as the heavens are high above the earth, so strong His mercy for those who fear Him. As far as the east is from the west, so far from us does He remove our transgressions. The Lord is compassionate and gracious, slow to anger and rich in mercy.
A reading from the letter of Saint Paul to the Romans. Brethren, none of us lives to himself, and none of us dies to himself. For if we live, we live to the Lord, and if we die, we die to the Lord. So then, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. For to this end Christ died and lived again, that He might be Lord both of the dead and of the living. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Kindly rise for the acclamation.
Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia.
A new commandment I give to you, says the Lord, that you love one another just as I have loved you.
Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, Peter came up and said to Jesus, Lord, how often will my brother sin against me and I forgive him? As many as 7 times? Jesus said to him, I do not say to you 7 times, but 70 times 7. Therefore, the kingdom of heaven may be compared to a king who wished to settle accounts with his servants. When he began to settle, one was brought to him who owed him 10,000 talents. And since he could not pay, his master ordered him to be sold, with his wife and children and all that he had, and payment to be made. So the servant fell on his knees, imploring him, Have patience with me, and I will pay you everything. And out of pity for him, the master of that servant released him and forgave him the debt. But when they came, the same servant went out. He found one of his fellow servants who owed him 100 denarii. And seizing him, he began to choke him, saying, Pay what you owe. So his fellow servant fell down and pleaded with him, Have patience with me, and I will pay you. He refused and went and put him in prison until he should pay the debt. When his fellow servants saw what had taken place, they were greatly distressed. And they went and reported to their master all that had taken place. Then his master summoned him and said to him, You wicked servant, I forgave you all the debt because you pleaded with me. And should not you have had mercy on your fellow servant as I had mercy on you? And in anger, his master delivered him to the jailers until he should pay all his debt. So also my heavenly Father will do to every one of you if you do not forgive your brother from your heart. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters, the readings of today bring forth a theme of forgiveness. There have been a lot of scientific studies in the recent past that has taken on this theme on forgiveness, especially to show the correlationship between forgiveness and physical health. The studies that have come out, especially in the medical science, have conclusively shown the relationship of having resentment, anger, hostility, feeling of vengeance within you to the physical health. They have concluded that forgiveness can result in good health. Forgiveness can lower your risk of blood pressure. Forgiveness can reduce your blood pressure. It can reduce the pain. It can reduce the level of stress, depression, anxiety, etc. Even ailments which are very common like diabetes seem to be connected with unforgiveness. So, my dear brothers and sisters, forgiveness can result in good health, whether it is a mental health, whether it is a physical health, whether it is a spiritual health. The readings of today also tell us the same thing. 2,000 years back, these readings which were written were for the people during those times and are still relevant for us today. In the book of Sirach, which we have read in the first reading, Jesus ben Sirach, who is the deliverer of these talks which are compiled in this book,
was a wise person, and therefore a lot of things which are stressed in this book are also seen in the gospel many a times. In this reading today, he speaks about sin with regard to its own consequences. He says that sin has its own consequences, which means he further says that anger and wrath, these are abomination and sinful to man. And when they hold it fast, you are bound to get retributions. In other words, he says that when you hold on an anger, when you hold on wrath against the other person, when you hold on these resentments, you are sinning against the Lord, and the Lord will also not forgive you. The Lord will also not allow you to keep this anger. So, my dear brothers and sisters, the sin has its own consequences, and therefore we need not keep the anger, resentment among ourselves. Further, he adds that we have to look at the end of times. Some of the writers say that it is the death that we have to look at. When we die, where are we going? If we are going to God, then we require His forgiveness. And therefore, Ben Sirach would say, look at the covenant and the commandment. At these end times, you will look at this, because based on this, you will be led to the heavenly kingdom. So therefore, you need not keep this resentment against your brother and sister in this life. In the second reading, in the letter of Saint Paul, writes to the people of the Romans. They were new Catholics, and therefore, when they had become a new Catholic, there were a lot of factions among them. One of the factions was these Gentiles, who were more liberal, and there were Jews who were more conservative. So there were constant discussion, differences that were going on among them. And Saint Paul writes to them with regard to building unity among them. And what does he say is that you all belong to Jesus Christ. You are belonging to Jesus Christ, therefore you are brothers and sisters. No matter there may be differences, the conservatives had their own judgment. The liberals would look down upon them. And Saint Paul would say that this is the responsibility of God to do that. You don't involve in that. You forgive each other because you belong to Jesus Christ. We are all brothers and sisters. Therefore, keeping resentment, keeping anger, keeping that vengeful feeling is not acceptable. In the gospel today too, we come across Matthew telling us with regard to the limits and conditions. He says there are no limits for forgiveness. Here is Peter coming to him and asking him, Lord, how often will my brother sin against me and I forgive him? As many as 7 times. We too ask many a times this question. That person is snapping at me again and again. That person is hitting me again and again. That person is hurting me, irritating me again and again. How many times should I forgive? And Jesus says there is no limit for forgiveness. He says 77 times, which means there is no limit for forgiveness. Because forgiveness has to be a continuous process. Forgiveness has to be an attitude of life which needs to be carried out by us. Further, it says the conditions that are required to forgiveness, why we should forgive. We should forgive because God forgives us again and again. And Jesus puts forth a parable before them. A parable about a person who has had to pay a debt, and the debt is huge, and the person forgives him his debt. But this first debtor has another debtor with a small amount, and he does not forgive the debt. And therefore, it is seen that because he has not forgiven the debt of the second debtor, the first debtor is not also forgiven. So therefore, the condition is that if you need to be forgiven by God, you need to forgive others, no matter what it is. My dear brothers and sisters, though it is easy to preach on forgiveness, It's difficult to practice. So therefore, why should I forgive the other person? I forgive the other person for my own good. When he hurts me and I feel hurt about it, I do not condone the act when I forgive him. I forgive for my own good. Because I need to come out of these negative feelings. I need to come out of this resentment. It is for my own good that I forgive the other person. Therefore, you are not forgiving to condone the act of the other person, but you are forgiving for your goodness. So when you are forgiving, you have that physical health. You are rewarded with mental health. You are rewarded with spiritual health. Because you have forgiven the other person, and these negative feelings has resulted in the positive feelings of doing good to other person. Secondly, why do we forgive? We forgive because no one over here is perfect. No one here on the earth is perfect. We all have our weaknesses. We all have our iniquities. Like the others hurt us, we too in our own ways hurt other people. We too in our own ways hurt God. Therefore, we need to remember this, that we too have our weaknesses, and therefore we need to forgive others. We see Jesus Christ on the cross. There are people who are mocking at him, who are making fun of him. There are people who are piercing arrow on him. And what does Jesus say? Please forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing. When a person is hurting us, there may be some circumstances that lead him to hurt us. When a person is snapping us, there is some belief system, there is something within him that is bothering him. That's the reason that he is hurting us. So therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, we have to acknowledge that we all are imperfect people, and therefore we need to forgive the other person. And thirdly, forgiveness is a choice. It is just not an act. It is a choice that you make which results in an act. And what happens over there in that choice? You are making an active conscious choice by which you do away the feeling of resentment, do away the feeling of vengeance. All these negative feelings are done away with an active choice. And when these feelings are done away with, the positive feelings come inside. The positive feelings of having empathy towards the other person, the positive feelings of having compassion towards the other person, and even the positive feelings of having affection to the person who has wronged you. So therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, forgiveness is a choice which you and I have to make in our lives. So let us make this choice. Let us make this choice against whom there have been resentments within our hearts. There has been difficulties within us to forgive them. We have to make this conscious choice for our own good. Let us ask the grace in today's Eucharist, who keeps on forgiving us, that he may grant his grace to forgive our fellow brethren. My dear brothers and sisters, the word of God pierces our hearts. It increases our faith, the faith in God. And therefore, let us all profess our faith, and together we say, I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters, hatred, hostility is like a poison that kills us. Let us ask the Almighty God,
and pray to him to help us to overcome this. Let us put forth our petitions before the Lord.
Let our response be, Lord, make us messengers of forgiveness. For the leaders of the church, that they may practice patience and forgiveness, we pray to the Lord. Lord, make us messengers of forgiveness. For civic leaders and leaders of nations, that they may prefer the path of dialogue and peace to settle disputes and conflicts, we pray to the Lord. Lord, make us messengers of forgiveness. For victims of crimes and evil, that they may find consolation in the word of Christ, that they may learn to forgive those who may have adversely affected their lives, we pray to the Lord. Lord, make us messengers of forgiveness. For those who are sick, that our loving and caring Father may look down on them with compassion and give them relief in their illness, we pray to the Lord. Lord, make us messengers of forgiveness. For those who take care of the sick in these times, that they may be strengthened in their ministry to the sick and the suffering, we pray to the Lord. Lord, make us messengers of forgiveness.
Let us ask this grace for our personal intentions too, for the people who have difficulties with us. Merciful God, you continue to forgive us even though there are a lot of transgressions that are there. Lord, you have been always merciful towards us. Grant us this grace to forgive and be merciful towards others. Be with us in times of this anger, hatred, resentment, that we may do away with these negative feelings and invite empathy, compassion, and affection within our hearts. And grant us the prayers that we have put forth before you. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Forgive our sins as we forgive. You taught us, Lord, to pray. But you alone can grant us grace to live the words we say. How can your pardon reach and bless the unforgiving heart that broods on wrongs and will not let old bitterness depart?
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be accepted to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Look with favor on our supplications, O Lord, and in your kindness accept these your servants' offerings, that what each has offered to the honor of your name may serve the salvation of all, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from the unending death, and by risking from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the host and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis our Pope and Philip Neri our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you, through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, In the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
My dear brothers and sisters, in our Father, we say, forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. We put a condition for our forgiveness, and God does not put any. So let us not put any conditions to forgive others, and ask the grace of the Lord in the prayer He Himself taught us to help us to do the same. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Make me a channel of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me bring your love. Where there is injury, your pardon, Lord. And where there's doubt, through faith in you. Make me a channel of your peace. Where there's despair in life, let me bring hope. Where there is darkness, only light. And where there's sadness, ever joy. O Master, grant that I may never sleep, so much to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love with all my soul. Make me a channel of your peace. It is in pardoning that we are pardoned, in giving to all men that we receive, and in dying that we are born to eternal life.
We cannot receive Jesus at this moment, sacramentally. So let us all recite an act of spiritual communion and experience the presence, the love, the forgiveness of Jesus. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament of the altar. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. May the working of this heavenly gift, O Lord, we pray, take possession of our minds and bodies, so that it affects and not our own desires may always prevail in us, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us call upon Mother Mary to intercede for us, especially in this pandemic, to protect our families. O Mary, you always shine on our path as a sign of salvation and of hope. We entrust ourselves to you, health of the sick, who at the cross took part in Jesus' pain, keeping your faith firm. O dear Mother, you know what we need, and we are sure you will provide it to us, so that, as in Cana of Galilee, we may return to joy and to feasting after this time of trial. Help us, Mother of Divine Love, to conform to the will of the Father and to do as we are told by Jesus, who has taken upon himself our sufferings and carried our sorrows, to lead us through the cross to the joy of the resurrection. Under your protection we seek refuge, Holy Mother of God. Do not disdain the entreaties of us who are in trial, but deliver us from every danger, O glorious and blessed Virgin. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Holy Virgin, by God's decree, you were called eternally, that he could give his Son to our race. Mary, we praise you, hail full of grace. Ave.